we've had just about every practice. We have had a wonderful time, and like Brother Bill said, some have lost it all, and praise the Lord. Just, you know, it's a wonderful piece of music. It tells the whole story of the birth of Jesus, and also talks about his resurrection, and talks about also the fact that we can have that promise of eternal life and salvation through Jesus Christ who came to this earth. So worship with us at this time as we present to you Emmanuel.
The Christmas story begins long before Mary, Joseph, and a manger in Bethlehem. Long before the angel proclaimed good tidings of great joy. You see, somewhere in eternity past, God planned his most magnificent of miracles. His Son, the King of all creation, would take upon himself the flesh of a man. And his name would be called Emmanuel, for he would save his people from their sins.
Imagine the King of Glory slipping into this world through the back door of a dirty, smelly stable. The word Messiah had such a lofty ring to it, and yet here he was, God, our long-awaited counselor, our day star, the Lion of the tribe of Judah.
Down through the ages, he had been called the King of the Jews, Lamb of God, and the Prince of Peace.
So many names apply to our Savior, but for those of us who have come to trust our lives to him, there is one name that falls from our lips more than any other.
Yeah.
And yet Mary knew, deep in her heart, she knew exactly who it was that she held in her arms. King that they could not touch, but was a God who could feel hurt and pain. a God who would shiver in a cold night, just so he can know how it felt to be them. And in the quiet moments when the guests are gone, baby Jesus slept in Mary's arms, and she pondered so much in her heart. She was so young herself, yet so trusted by God. In the midst of the joys of new motherhood, her mind must have been racing with a million whys and what ifs. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon.
Reveal me, Lord.
self nature of his name gave him complete and total victory over sin and a cruel and agonizing cross. Jesus, our Emmanuel, arose from the grave with resurrection majesty and splendor that changed the course of history once and for all time. Just as surely as he made a place in the stable and in our world, the Christ of Bethlehem desires to make a place within us. As we celebrate his birth, we also celebrate the new birth that we find only in him. When Christ comes to live within the heart of man, that heart will change. Murmurs of hurt will be replaced by sweet songs of praise.
Clamoring of disillusionments and anger transform and change into anthems of hope and joy.
The God of heaven gave us his child, and anyone who will invite him in can find life that never ends. It's just as simple as this prayer. Lord, just as you came to the world in Bethlehem that night so long ago, I ask you to come to me now. Prepare my heart to be your Bethlehem and be born into my life. Change me, releasing his heart from the curse of sin and death, and make my heart your home, now and always.
You live on.
all that we can never be. Let every heart who has found life in Him rejoice, for God makes all things new.
Rejoice, for the kingdom of God is within you. Rejoice, for we are no longer bound by the laws of sin and flesh, but we live in grace and peace forever. Let every heart echo the song of the angels. Rejoice, for Mary's wonderful child, Emmanuel, has come.
Whereby a man can be saved except Jesus Christ.